Hello, everyone, and welcome to my review of Thor,
The Dark World.
Yes, the 2013 sequel to the 2011 Thor movie, Thor, The Dark World, directed by Alan Taylor, starring Chris Hemsworth and all the cast from the first movie, along with some new ones. And this is actually a film that takes place in the second phase of the MCU after the events of Avengers Assemble. So it's more of a sequel to that movie, really, as well as the first Thor movie. So, in preparation for Thor Ragnarok, I said in my previous review that I'm going to be reviewing the first two Thor movies as well. So now we've reached the second one, Thor The Dark World. So, the basic story of this film is that it takes place a couple of years after the first one. basically, there's this whole hullabaloo about this thing called the Aether. And then somehow, Natalie Portman's character, for no reason, Jane Foster, comes across the Aether and it ends up going inside her. Don't ask me how, don't ask me why, but that's what happens. And then Thor finds her again, they reunite, and then he takes her to Asgard and they have to try and get this thing out of her and stop this evil elf lord Malekith, played by Christopher Eccleston, from achieving it. And basically what happens is that there is a sort of big scientific event that's going to occur called a convergence, where all these realms, all the nine realms will align, and the world will be destroyed as we know it, and that's pretty much it. And you've also got Kat Dennings and Stellan Skarsgard who return as well, for no reason. So, Thor The Dark World. Now, I went back to Thor The Dark World having not seen this movie for a while. I think I'd seen it once at the cinema when it came out, and then I'd seen it once sort of when it came onto DVD. So I was never really curious. I was curious to go back and watch it, but I didn't know how my opinion was going to fare. And I'm sorry to say, guys, but it's actually a lot worse than I remember it to be. Thor The Dark World. Believe me, guys, I really tried. I tried to like this movie, but I just can't. I just can't. It's terrible. And that really saddens me, because you have a great cast in this movie. But for me, Thor The Dark World is one of the worst movies in the MCU. I'm sorry. It's not the fact that it's a mess. It's not that. It's not even a mess. Like, the story's fine. There's no bad construction in the story. I mean, there's certain errors with the characters, but I'll get to those in a minute. I just think the biggest problem with this movie is that it is empty. It is nothing. There is nothing in this movie. It is a nothing movie. And I can now confirm to you that it is my least favourite of the trilogy. My review of Thor Ragnarok will be coming soon. I just don't think the story amounts to a hill of beans. It just doesn't. And that really affects the storytelling for me. I mean, the story's so basic that, I mean, whilst the first movie had an interesting commentary on science and magic and how the two interweaved, and it also told a great moral story about Thor, and, you know, his character arc was really interesting. This ain't got diddly squat. This movie ain't got nothing. I mean, you know, it's certainly intriguing at the start, but then afterwards, it's just fucking boring. It just goes on and on and on. It's like, oh, the convergence, oh, mumbo jumbo. Like, there's so much talking, and they stand around, they talk, then there's an action scene. Oh. They stand around, they talk, then there's an action scene. It just keeps going and going and going. I mean, it's not a long movie. It's not even 2 hours long, but it feels longer than it is. And I just started to get really bored. I think another sort of major problem with this movie is bringing back certain characters that didn't need to come back. Why was Natalie Portman in this movie? You didn't need to bring her back. There was no need. I mean, despite her best efforts, don't get me wrong, Natalie Portman gives a fine performance. She's fine in this movie. She doesn't look like she wants to be there, but she's fine. She doesn't... she gives a harmless performance, but the character had no reason to be there. And what's worse, more than Natalie Portman being there, is Darcy and Selvig being in the movie. I mean, I can understand Selvig a little bit. I mean, it is quite funny seeing him running around naked and he's going stir crazy. That was cool. But including Darcy again, and Darcy has this new intern. What the fuck? Why are they in it? And, you know, the fact that they use her for more comic relief. The first movie was fine, I could deal with it, because it wasn't so much. This time, they really lay it on thick. You know, they're trying their hardest to make her the comic relief character. And she just comes across as really annoying. And her intern as well, he's pointless. I don't know why he's in it. And then, you know, at the end of the movie, they spark a romance when he saves her life. How the hell is he able to pick up a bloody car and throw it across onto the things? When did he get superpowers? What? What the fuck? I mean, that made no sense to me. And then they, you know, they'd start snogging and stuff. I mean, the attempts at humour in this movie are just so poor. I mean, it doesn't have the same intrigue as the first movie. And Christopher Eccleston as the villain, despite his best efforts, he tries his best, but the villain sucks. Malekith is a shit villain. He's one of the worst villains of the MCU. I mean, he looks cool. He looks scary. I mean, the fact that he's like this dark elf, but there is no character there. There is nothing. And, you know, he's an utter bore to watch. Not because of Christopher Eccleston, but because of the writing. He's just this evil villain. He wants this thing to destroy the world. It's so recycled. It's been done before. You know, there's a lot of problems with this movie. And Tom Hiddleston as Loki, while he is the best performance in the movie, he can't save it. The movie is boring and dull. It just goes on. And, oh, look, my emotional blackmail detector. Oh, they kill off Loki 3/4 of the way into the movie. What the hell? It doesn't do anything. Why did you do that? I mean, the ending was quite cool when we see that Loki takes the throne of Asgard somehow. I don't know how. But, you know, the movie's just dull. And, you know, when the action comes, it's cool. But it doesn't do anything for me. Not like the first one did. And there is more action than the first one. So I guess that was, you know, nice. I don't think it's a total failure, but it is a terrible movie. What do I like about it? Well, it's nice to actually see an MCU movie set in London for a change. There's a scene towards the beginning of the movie where Jane is on like a date in London with Chris O'Dowd has a cameo, which is nice. And then the climax of the movie takes place in London. So I definitely appreciated that. And there's quite a funny moment when Thor himself goes on a train. He says, "How do I get to Greenwich?" And then there's a woman says, "Oh, take this train, 3 stops." And then he gets on the train. it is quite funny. So I do think some of the moments are quite good. And Chris Hemsworth as Thor continues to be pretty solid. I like his performance in this movie, and he does give a much more grounded performance because now. Now he's learned, since the first movie, he's had his character arc. We now see him as a good guy. You know, he's just doing what he can. I mean, he's still recklessly impulsive, and he does disobey his father. He doesn't listen to his father, but he doesn't have that smug, you know, big-headedness or arrogance that he had in the first one. So he's definitely come a long way. We've seen him come far, but in this movie, he obviously has issues with trust with Loki. The whole thing with Thor and Loki is just confusing to me. Like, one minute they like each other, then they don't. He trusts him, then he doesn't. It goes back and forth and back and forth. What are we supposed to think? You know, what are we supposed to think? I mean, Tom Hiddleston as Loki, he is great in this movie. He doesn't get much to do, though. In the first half of the movie, he's in prison because, if you remember, in the Avengers Assemble, he's the main villain of that movie. So he's being imprisoned on Asgard for his crimes. But obviously then Thor needs his help and breaks him out of prison. And then, they just kill Loki, which is stupid. well, kill Loki in inverted commas. like I said, the action is cool when it happens, but it's still sometimes the movie just goes on. I mean, towards the end, I started to fall asleep. That might have been because I watched it quite late at night. But there is no substance to this movie. I just think Alan Taylor's direction is very bad. It's not great. Apart from one scene, the best scene of the movie, I have to say, is, I mean, spoiler alert, if you haven't seen the movie, turn away now, the death of the Queen, Frege. I mean, I thought that was very well done, when she was stabbed, and then we cut to her funeral. The funeral scene was beautiful. That was really well directed. Couldn't we have more of that, please? Just like on a visual level as well. I mean, with the music, it was beautiful the way they sort of, the lights were sending up, and then the boat goes over the waterfall and then just slowly crumbles to ashes. And it was a really beautiful moment in the movie, and it was the best scene of the movie. The fact that that scene stood out as being the best of the movie, not because she died, but because of the way the scene was constructed, because of how good that was, proved to me how badly the rest of the movie hung up. I mean, if I were to rank it in the MCU, I'd probably put it second from bottom. I mean, it's better than The Incredible Hulk, in my opinion, because it's a bit more watchable, and there's a bit more action. But The Incredible Hulk is an equally not great movie. I never got into that movie. I mean, with this one, I used to like it, but I just couldn't get into it. It's just a complete boring fest, and I don't think the plot is very good. The plot is nothing. It's a nothing movie. It's so empty. It lacks so much substance, apart from that funeral scene, which is really well done. The first half is boring. The second half is boring. It's boring, and is probably my least favourite movie in the Thor series, and one of my least favourite MCU movies. It's such a shame. It really is such a shame. I mean, one thing I will say about Thor, The Dark World, is that it's not too reliant on nostalgia like some of the other movies, which is nice. I'm thankful for that, because a lot of the other MCU movies can be so overly nostalgic, and it can bother me slightly. With this one, they only had a couple of cameos. They had a cameo from Chris Evans, actually, as Captain America. So that was nice. That was funny. It was done in a tongue-in-cheek kind of way, which is good. I will say, actually, the visuals from this movie are just as good as the first one, and the design of the movie looks great. It looks like definitely like a big-budget production, and Anthony Hopkins also does another good job as Odin. It's a pretty-looking film. It looks great, but man, oh man, is it poorly constructed, and it's just a film without so much substance. You didn't need to bring back Jane. You didn't need to bring back Darcy. Maybe you didn't need to bring back Selvig, but I didn't mind him being there. What can I say? And I didn't think the soundtrack was as good this time either. They should have kept the same theme from the first one. Thankfully, Thor Ragnarok brings it back a little bit. But yeah, I mean, Thor the Dark World, it's rubbish. It's rubbish, but it's not completely rubbish, but it is very, very disappointing. Like I said, a few little things that really did, you know, make it at least worth a while, like the action sequences, the cameo from Chris Evans, the performances, are good, and, like, having some of the films set in London was nice, but, yeah, and its attempts at humour just are cringeworthy. Kat Dennings is annoying, and I'm glad that they cut those characters out of the third one, because you didn't need them at all. So I'm going to give Thor the Dark World a very low 4 out of 10. Yeah, it's pretty bad. But yeah, as the MCU goes, this one is just not great. I mean, whether I keep this in my collection, I don't know. I may if I like Thor Ragnarok enough again, because I have seen it already, but I will watch it again. If I like the third one enough to buy it, then I might keep this one just to have it in the collection. But it's not one that I plan to rush back to very much. So, that's my review of Thor the Dark World. What do you guys think of it? Do you agree? Do you disagree? Put your comments down below. Let me know. And stay tuned for my review of the third Thor movie, Thor Ragnarok. Until then, thank you all for watching. And as always, I'm Mr. TARDIS11. See ya.